Ernie said, talk loud and very short. Glad to be back in Oklahoma. I'm from Oklahoma City. Okay. I actually played with the Ernie Fields Orchestra, his father's band, when I was 15. I played the song better than we do now. We played three nights in Rolla, Missouri, Springfield, and Tulsa. And I just want to say, you know, the Oklahoma drummers mean so much to me. I have a couple of them tonight. Jamie Oldacre's here. I think Jamie Oldacre, Jimmy Tomstein. I think Cleve Warren. And I always have my love to Jim Kelder who couldn't be here. Thank you.
I had to tell you a couple of stories about my daddy said, because I would get mad about some segregation and stuff. He would say, listen, man, there are good white people. So, I'm going to tell you about a couple of good white people situations. It was against the law in certain states, and I know it was in Louisiana, to have an integrated band. And so my daddy had a Jewish dude. Played his ass off on saxophone, you know. So they were in New Orleans, and up was coming the sheriff. He saw the badges and stuff coming toward the bandstand, and the guy ran over and said, hey, I was just telling them, that Geechee you got up there looks like a white boy. I said, you know, he sure does look like he's white, boy. You know, that's one good white person. The other tale I'm going to tell you about, these are true stories, I got them. They were, this was in 1942 when gas was rationed and it was segregation also. And Daddy's bus had stopped and it was freezing cold. And he said he didn't have enough gas in the bus to spend all night long and stay warm, go 300 miles to the next gig. Where there wasn't a hotel to stay in also. So he went to the sheriff and said, could we stay in jail here to stay in the bar? The sheriff said, you niggas ain't done nothing. So they went outside and threw a rock through a window. Sheriff came out there with his deputy and said, okay, which one of you niggas did that? Nobody said anything. All right, I'm taking all you niggas to jail. All you niggas to jail. They were warm all night long, and the deputies didn't see him do anything wrong. You dig what I mean, Jelly Bean? Okay. So those are two stories. Now we got to go on from there to tell you about some country musicians. You youngsters only know Blake Shelton and Garth Brooks. Carrie Underwood. Now Ricky's responsible for developing Carrie Underwood. And she got an American Idol. But I gotta tell another story. Good white folks, y'all. Okay. I was in Daddy's bus then. The Ozark Mountain boys were coming down the hill. The bus had broken down. Something's wrong. And they pulled over and stopped and said, what's wrong? Can we help you? So anyway, to make a long story a little shorter, they hooked onto the bus and pulled it onto town. I know that we were coming from Missouri, Lincoln University in Missouri. And so we stopped at this little town, and the Ozark Mountain boys would not go. They said, we want to wait until the place opens, it's going to fix your bus. And what I was thinking, then they wanted to make sure that they would serve colored people, you know. So when the next morning when it opened up, the Ozark Mountain Boys, they walked out to them and said, what can I do for you? They said, you can help these men by fixing their bus and charging. And so the guys kind of looked like, said, now are you going to do that? They said, yeah. And they said, okay, we'll see you, Ernie. And pull on off. And then, okay. That's okay. Now, we are in here, we're in Kane's Ballroom, because Bob Wills told Kane's We're talking about country people now. Bob Wills told Kane, if he didn't let Ernie Fields play in here and start letting colored people come in, he would not come in here anymore. And that would influence a lot of Okay. So I got some. Wait a minute. First of all, no, yeah. Am I supposed to?
You're good.
Okay. I got some Bob Wills. I got Daddy talking about Bob Wills first. Is that right? Right. Okay.
That they wanted me to play, but 60% of some Bob Wills. So Bob Wills, he said, I would ask him maybe for a little more percentage than that. Says, can me not have 70. Instead of just 100, I would play for 125 that salary. He said, man, don't be giving yourself away for that. I mean, you're honest. Because you don't be selling himself for $125.
But that's Bob Wills giving advice to Daddy about the clubs that were white clubs. In other words, you should not get 60%, you should get 70%, you know. So we also know that Bob Wills had a guitar player, steel guitar player named Leon McCullough, that had a joint here in Tulsa, a big club. Yeah, a big club, you know. And Leon, I talk too much, because Leon would send musicians down to Daddy, you know, white musicians. And Daddy would integrate his band with him, and we had, I'll have to tell this story. Leon McCullough sent him one saxophone player, and Daddy hired him, and they started traveling, and he got sick in Denver. So Daddy had to leave him in Denver, but he left him with my mother's sister's family. So he got some good black people too.